I'm right over here. Why can't you see me? Oh no. And I'm giving it my all, but I'm not the guy you're taking home. Ooh, I keep dancing on my own.
Well, I am so frickin' excited, it's got to be said, to be backstage on tour with the one and only Callum Scott. Now listen, this guy is so talented. It's kind of like Sam Smith and Adele give birth to him and Leona Lewis is his auntie. He's that good. Callum, how are you doing?
That is the most incredible image. But yeah, that's a massive compliment. I'm so good. I'm so excited. First day of tour and I couldn't think of a better place to play. I mean, I've said from day one, Ireland in general is one of my favourite countries to play in. So to start my tour here in Ireland is just a dream come true for me.
Okay, well, the Academy, this is where we are at the minute, is such a cool venue as well. Now, your album came out, Only Human, about a month ago. I've it on repeat in my car ever since. I'm a little bit of a fan. I hope I don't fanboy too much here. Anyway, I'll try and keep it cool. But love the record. It really seems like you poured your whole heart and soul into it.
Oh, mate, yeah. And I'm so grateful. Like, comments like that is just unreal because I've been living with these songs for some of them a year and a half. So to hear people have the album and to be playing it and to be enjoying it just means the absolute world. And like you said, I definitely put my heart and soul into this record. I talked a lot about personal situations that I've been through and experiences I've been through, but did it with the hope that it inspires people and, you know, people picking their favorites and saying that sort of stuff is just, it just gives me goosebumps. I love that.
Okay, we've got to talk as well about Leona Lewis. I've got a little bit of an unhealthy obsession with Leona Lewis. Yeah, you are the reason. What an incredible duet. And imagine, first of all, having her singing on your song. But second of all, it seems like you've become best friends. Everybody is loving this. You're like, she's like your sister from another mister. Is that what you're going to call it?
Literally, she's like a bestie. I don't know where it came from. I think, you know what? I think really from the day that we started talking over email, it was just very clear to me that she was a very normal girl, incredible talent, but still very normal, very approachable and could talk to her and have a laugh, have banter. And when I met her, it was exactly that. I mean, we've been separated many times just because of how silly we are. And I think probably the unspoken bond we probably had was that we've both come from a talent show and we've both kind of really stuck in the hard work and come out the other side of it. So I think that was always something that connected us more. But just being nice and just being, you know, a down-to-earth person is what I think cemented the bond. But she definitely is like a sister from another mister to me. It's ridiculous. Separate at birth, I would probably say.
Now, are you going to return the favour and record a duet for her next album? Give us a bit of a scoop, Callum. Come on.
Well, all I can say is when we was introduced, I sent her some of my work. She sent me some of hers. And we worked on each other's projects. So that's all I can say. I mean, I would jump at the opportunity to work with her again and do something else with her, but we'll have to wait and see what comes out with Leona's new music, which I'm anticipating so much. She's been gone for so long, and I can't wait to hear what she's been up to.
Okay, I'm going to take that as an absolutely 100% yes. No. Callum, you, of course, shot to fame on Britain's Got Talent. I actually wrote a book about fame a couple of years back, a whole book about the look of the celebrity world. So how do you like your celebrity status? Do you enjoy it?
I do. It was a bit hard to get used to because I must admit, you know, going from a normal 9-to-5 guy to then suddenly having an audience that was from every corner of the world is quite a transition. Yes. And, you know, even so much as having my picture taken in public with people and being noticed and people like going crazy. Like I have some really enthusiastic fans that just go like crazy as if I'm like Justin Bieber. And I still consider myself that lad from the northeast of England. Like I don't consider myself anything special like that, you know? So that was quite hard to get used to, but you become comfortable and you become, I mean, especially for me in this industry, I feel because I'm talking about such sensitive subjects that I now have a voice that I can use for the better. So, I mean, I've kind of stepped into that role and almost taken on a different responsibility rather than just being a, you know, a public figure and kind of, I want to sort of do something with my voice and do something with my influence and stuff like that. So, fingers crossed, you know, I can put a little bit more love into the world. I think that's what we need right now.
Absolutely. That's one of the most amazing things about fame. And now the glitz, the glamour, the parties and everything. Do you think it's such a crazy world?
Yeah. Oh my God, it's just insane. When I think about who I've met, I mean, just the other day I was talking to my manager and he said, oh, you remember that time when we had lunch with Sting? And I'm like, yes, I do. And that's just so random to me still. You know, Katy Perry, Sam Smith, some of the One Direction boys. I've met so many incredible people and it's still kind of a pinch me moment that I'm amongst these names and I'm circulating in these circles, but I'm still very normal, still down to earth, still got a lot of time for my friends, you know, still go back home to Hull a lot and party with my friends back in the old clubs I used to party in and stuff, just to remain grounded, because these celebrity parties are crazy. Sometimes I'm like, how did I end up here?
I know, I've watched some of your interviews on YouTube. Now, you've had some of the most hilarious and at times bonkers interviews. You've been interviewed while eating pizza. You've played innuendo bingo. But the best one was, I was watching some interviews where they were in different languages and you just had to sit there really awkwardly while they were translating and explaining the questions for you. Is that a real unusual interview experience?
I mean, you can tell just by the laughter. I mean, it's so bizarre. I had a guy in I was in Singapore and he'd flown in from Indonesia, I think, and was I think the interview you're on about, he sings You Are the Reason in a different language. Yeah. And he gives me two versions and asks me what I think is the real version. And he passionately delivered this song, this rendition of You Are the Reason. And I was like, it must be the first one. And he's like, no. He was like, the first one I was talking about, I was in a meeting, I had some stomachache and I had to fart. And I was like, but you delivered that so passionately, I thought it was You Are the Reason. Like, it's just some of the most bonkers interviews, but I love all that. Because don't get me wrong, I love talking about, because it's been so long since I've been able to confidently talk about my sexuality, I love talking about the sort of more touchy subjects and a bit more, you know, raw subjects like sexuality and all that kind of stuff. But I also love doing the fun stuff as well, like having a glass of water in my mouth and not being able to spit it out whilst being told the most ridiculous innuendos. It's...
Oh no, you've ruined my next question. That's what I was just about to do here.
Yeah. Bottle of water on standby. I've got my rain mac on, so I'm all right.
No, forget Britain's Got Talent for a second. This is Callum's Got Talent. Get it? See what I did there? Callum's Got Talent. What is your secret talent that nobody knows about? You can't have told us in other interviews. We need another secret talent.
A different secret talent. Have you seen me bark? I can bark. Okay, so
dog.
Yes, but you know, I would love to be, you know, somebody who could bark. If we're talking on the scale of barking, I would quite like to be somebody who would bark like a really ferocious, big, muscular dog.
Yeah.
But I bark like a small chihuahua.
Oh, I love chihuahuas. They're actually my favorite dog.
There you go. I mean, I can give you a demonstration.
Okay, go for it. This is Callum Scott barking.
To limber up a little bit.
It's maybe my favorite radio moment of all time.
I better do a good back one. Right, you ready?
Okay, will I count you down?
Yeah.
Okay, 3, 2, 1. Oh my God, it was literally like I was interviewing a chihuahua.
I just came out of your little bag and barked and went away.
This was more amazing than I could ever have imagined. I've got to let you go in a second, Callum, and I've just got to ask you. You've been singing about dancing on your own for the last couple of years. I'm actually an Irish dancing teacher. That's my other completely random away from media career. So I've been dancing since I was a kid. So I'm a pretty good judge. I've got to ask you, can you dance?
I would love to, and I just can't. I even said to my manager, I was like, do you think I should be taking up some dance lessons? And he was like, well, yes. But he was like, you know, for the tour, just do what you do, sing. We'll look at dancing at some other point. But I'm kind of like a dad dancer, and it upsets me. I wish I had more moves.
Have you got a go-to kind of move? You know, when under pressure, I have to do something move.
Yeah, I suppose that kind of like the foot shuffle that you do. I go to that, and then once that's spent, I'm like, guys, that's it, I'm done. If there's ever a dance circle and there's a dance-off, if I pull that move out early, then I just got to pray they don't come back to me. Because then it's going to be the chicken and it's going to be the running man. And I don't want to crank out those old moves, mate. I think they've had their time.
And finally then, Callum, I love my shirts. I'm big into my style. Even though I'm not actually wearing one today, I'm trying to rock this look like I'm 18-year-old jacket, even though I'm double the age of that.
I must admit, when I came in, I felt like you look like a choreographer.
Okay, that's cool, yeah, I think. I wanted to look like I was like an 18-year-old in a hip-hop kind of video. So that's actually the perfect look I was going for. But I was going to ask you, you've got some serious shirt game. Are you big into style? Love your shirts.
Thank you, sir. I've just actually had my stylist send me a whole bunch of stuff up for the tour, and it's such a cool look. I'm a big guy into shirts. I love like the whole cool, different sort of style shirts. So I'm going to be cranking a couple of those out for the tour. And I'm also going to go into trousers this time. I'm usually a jeans and boots kind of guy, but I think I'm going to rock the trousers on this one.
Controversial.
Controversial Callum, that's what they call me.
Well, Callum, I can't wait for your show later on tonight. Thank you so much for taking the time to join us. We love you as well on our radio station. So cheers and best of luck with everything.
Thank you so much. And thank you to all your listeners for all the support. Hope to see as many of you there tonight as I can.
I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what I've broken. 'Cause I